dear learners for this course on engineering graphics. In our module 5 we were discussing about isometric projection. Let us continue our discussion on isometric projection. The problem number 7 of our discussion states that a sphere of diameter 30 mm rests on the frustum of hexagonal pyramid of base 30 mm and top face 80 mm side with height 50 mm such that their axis coincide. Draw the isometric projection of combination of solids. In our previous lecture, I have explained you how to draw the isometric projection of single solids. Let us begin our discussion on combination of solids. If you clearly observe the problem, there is a sphere resting on the top face of the frustum of hexagonal pyramid. Let us draw the front view and top view of the given problem first. If I draw the front view and top view of the given problem, it will be, first let us construct the frustum of hexagonal pyramid. If I do that, in the top view the base is a hexagon of side 30 mm. So therefore, drawing vertical line of side is equal to 30 mm. The same line which is 30 mm as radius, construct a circle. Now, keeping the same length which is 30 mm, cut arcs at equal intervals to get the hexagon. Now, joining these arcs, I'll get hexagon with edge on either side. This completes the top view of the frustum of hexagonal pyramid. That is a hexagon of side which is equal to 30 mm. I have drawn such a way that I get edge on both sides. If you want to do with corner on both sides, you can do, that is also correct. So now take the projection and mark the height of the axis. So the height of the frustum of hexagonal pyramid is given as 50 mm. So now if I take the projection and also removing the construction, I will get marking the axis of this frustum of hexagonal pyramid, the height is given as 50 mm. Now, again, from the center, construct one more hexagon which represents the top face of this frustum of hexagonal pyramid. So, the side length of the top face hexagon is 80 mm. So, therefore, from the same center, you construct one more hexagon of side length is equal to 80 mm. So now to construct that, from the same center you mark 80 mm vertical line. Using this 80 mm as radius, construct a very thin circle. With the same 80 mm dimension, cut arcs at equal intervals. Join these arcs to complete the hexagon in the top face of this frustum of hexagonal pyramid. Remove this construction circle and also take the projection vertically upwards. Now take the projection in the front view whose length is equal to the length of the axis, that is 50 mm. Now join these two projections at a height of 50 mm to represent the top face of this frustum of hexagonal pyramid and join the corners to represent the slack edges. Now join the respective corners in the top view, which will give us the triangular faces in the crest of this hexagonal pyramid. So these six faces represent the apparent triangular faces which are formed by crest of this hexagonal pyramid. So this completes the front view and also the top view of the custom of hexagonal pyramid required. Now show the dimensions. Now on the top of this frustum of hexagonal pyramid we have a sphere of diameter 30 mm. So therefore taking 15 mm as radius, construct a circle in the top view, and also taking the axis height as 15 mm, construct a circle in the front view. If I do that, constructing a circle of radius 15 mm, measure a height of 15 mm above the frustum of this hexagonal pyramid. So, marking the center of this sphere, construct a circle of radius 15 mm. Now, dark this front view. Showing the dimensions of this sphere, the diameter of this sphere is 30 mm. This completes the required front view and top view of the combination of solid what he has asked. Now to draw the isometric projection, as I explained in our previous lectures, enclose this hexagon in a rectangle and transfer that hexagon to the isometric projection. Using that we can construct the frustum of hexagonal pyramid. That is, first you construct a rectangle around this hexagonal laminae. If I do that, I'll get, now measure the dimension of this rectangle. If I measure the dimensions, I am getting the dimension as 60 mm cross 50 mm. Now transfer this rectangle of dimension 60 mm cross 50 mm to the isometric sheet. That is, select two lines on the isometric sheet which are inclined at an angle of 30 degrees. Let me take this point as the reference. If I take this point as the reference, I will get towards my right the 50 mm side, and towards my left I will get the 60 mm side. So therefore, towards my right I should construct 5 boxes. Choosing 5 boxes, draw a very thin line. Choosing 6 boxes, you draw a very thin line. Now, drawing the parallel lines, this completes the isometric projection of rectangle of dimension 50 mm cross 60 mm. In the ISO sheet, it is 5 boxes cross 6 boxes. Now, transfer this hexagon to the isosceles. So if we measure these two corners on the 60 mm side are at a distance of 50 mm from either side. So therefore, mark 1.5 boxes similarly in the parallel side also you mark 1.5 boxes from either corners. Through the visual inspection itself we can state that on a 50 mm side this corner is exactly at the center. So that is, this corner is at a distance of 25 mm or 25 mm from both the sides of this rectangle. So therefore, mark 2.5 boxes on 5 boxes side, joining which I will get the isometric projection of hexagon when the laminate is horizontal. This construction should be of very very thin line. This completes the isometric projection of hexagon of side 30 millimeters. So now mark the center of this hexagon. Now from the center O1 measure the height of the frustum. The height of the frustum is 50 millimeters. So measuring 5 boxes vertically upwards and mark center O2. Now with this center O2 I should construct the inner hexagon with the side length is equal to 18 millimeters. So to transfer this hexagon of side length 18 millimeters, first we enclose this in a rectangle. If I do that, I get if I measure the rectangle constructed around the top face of this frustum of this hexagonal pyramid, it is measuring a rectangle of dimension 36 millimeters cross 34 millimeters. So therefore, transfer this 36 millimeters cross 34 millimeters rectangle to the isometric sheet with center O2. So now to do that, I want the grid sheet. So if I construct the grid sheet with center O2, I'll get now to transfer this 32 millimeters cross 36 millimeters rectangle, let me take this as corner as the reference. If I take this corner as the reference, I'll get 32 millimeters side towards my right and 36 millimeters side towards my left. So therefore, from center O2 you offset 1.6 boxes and 1.6 boxes, 1.6 boxes upward and 1.6 boxes downward. So if I do that, I'll get Now transfer this 36 mm side, you offset 80 mm, that is 1.8 boxes towards left and 1.8 boxes towards right side. So if I do that using 1.8 boxes, towards left and 1.8 boxes towards right. So constructing the rectangle, I'll get so this completes the rectangle enclosing the hexagon of side 18 millimeters, which is measuring 3.2 boxes and 3.6 boxes. So now transfer the corners 36 millimeters side, mark the corners, getting these two corners at a distance of 10 millimeters from either side. So therefore marking one boxes from either side, similarly you mark one boxes from either side. Now this is exactly at the center, so therefore you mark exact center on the 32 mm side. Construct the hexagon. Joining these markings, I will get the hexagon of side 18 millimeters in the isometric projection on an iso sheet. So this completes the isometric projection of hexagon of side 18 millimeters. So now with the same center O2, you measure a height of 1.5 boxes, because the true radius of this sphere is 15 millimeters. So from O2 you measure 1.5 boxes to represent the iso 15 mm radius of the sphere. That is, taking 1.5 boxes vertically upwards, mark center O3. That is between center O2 to O3, you have 1.5 boxes. Which represents the iso radius of the sphere. Now we already know that sphere is the exceptional case in the isometric projection. Even in the isometric projection, the sphere represents the true dimension. So therefore, keeping at center O3, measuring true radius of 15 millimeters, not 1.5 boxes, true radius of 15 millimeters from your compass, keeping it O3, draw a circle to represent the sphere. The careful observation shows that from center O2 to O3, we have iso radius of 15 millimeters for the sphere, and the radius of the sphere, that is the actual radius of this sphere, is 15 millimeters. This completes the isometric projection of sphere of diameter 30 millimeters. The distance from O3 to O2 is isoradius 15 millimeters, and the distance from O3 to circumference is true radius of 15 millimeters. Now, through the visual inspection, dark all the visible edges. If I dark all the visible edges through the visual inspection, I will get the sphere is completely visible. So therefore, dark the sphere. And the top face edges of the hexagon, which are partly visible, and also these three edges are completely visible, so dark them. Coming for the longer edges, the visible longer edges are longer edge number 1, longer edge number 2, longer edge number 3, and longer edge number 4. And in the base, edge 1, 2, and 3 are visible edges. So, visible base edge 1. Visible base edge 2 and visible base edge 3. So this completes the isometric projection of given combined solid. In isometric projection, one should not show any invisible edges, any construction lines or any angles. Therefore, remove all construction lines, invisible edges and invisible curves. So if I do that, the final diagram of the isometric projection will look like this. Completes the isometric projection of given combination of solid after removing the invisible and construction lines. One careful observation one has to make is that from center O2 to O3, it should be isoradius, that is 0.815 times the 15 millimeters, that is 1.5 boxes in your ISO sheet. But from center O3, you should draw the circle to the actual radius of 15 millimeters. So this is the front view of the given combination of solids. This is the top view of the given combination of solids, and this is the isometric projection of given combination of solids. Try to draw this isometric projection by taking the corner on either side and look how does this isometric projection look like. That's all from this lecture. Thank you.